Okay, and welcome back. And today we're going to be making a picture frame. Now I know some of you are thinking, no, not another picture frame. But this one's actually a birthday present for my brother, which is tomorrow. So I need to get on with it pretty quick. What I've done is I've actually gone on eBay and I've bought this page out of a catalogue. I see, probably think it's a bit of a weird present, but he's really into his old cutthroat type razors, his razor paraphernalia, shaven paraphernalia rather, all the leather strops in the old razors and whatnot. So I bought this old page out of a 1920s catalogue. It's got strops on one side and razors on the other. It's got like prices and what the handles are made out of and stuff like that on there. It's quite a nice thing, unusual I think, so it'd be quite a nice feature on the wall in a nice frame. As you can see here, you've got the razors on one side and the strops on the other. And what I've actually done is I've copied one side because I want to view both of them in the frame. So what I've done is I've actually photocopied one side and printed it out as near the quality as I can. But obviously you'll never get it exactly the same. As you can see here, there is a slight difference. The yellowing on the aging isn't quite right and the black isn't quite as good. I have got a photo printer, but I don't think you'll ever get it exactly right unless you take it to a proper printing firm, I don't think. So anyway, what we're going to be using for this project is some nice maple, which I've got here, which I've had for a little while. I think I've had this planned for a little while, to be honest. But it wasn't actually intended for that. But this is what we're going to be using. I'm also going to be using this mahogany here. My intention is to, because it's from a 20s catalogue, is to go for these sort of Art Deco sort of looks. So what I'm going to do is cut some strips out of this, and I'm going to inlay them into the maple here, and hopefully it should give that sort of nice clean, those nice clean lines of an Art Deco look. So what you need to do first, just measure out these maple pieces and cut them down to size. Now, as one of these pieces is a little bit higher than the rest, I've decided just to plane it down a bit. Okay, so I'm about to route out the part from the insert. So all I've done here is I've set a block here as a stop block, so I know exactly where to stop when I'm routing, because I don't want the insert to go all the way through. I just want it to come a certain distance, and that should look quite nice, I think. So what we need to do now is just take out these rounded corners, make them square, and sand out any little bits of wood sticking out. Brought the sun and the flowers where there used to be rain. My yesterday was blue, dear. Today I'm part of you. My lonely night thoughts. It doesn't need to be really smooth sandpaper, just to get the rough edges out. Should fit in quite snug. What we need to do now is cut down these strips of mahogany and then start gluing them in. And then we're having a nice cup of tea. Don't be shy with the glue when doing this, because we can always wipe it off, the excess off, with a wet cloth. You want to get all the sides, because you want this to be glued in good and proper, because it doesn't just act, well I don't believe it just acts as a piece of decoration, but it also acts as a strengthening piece where you've routed out. Because obviously where you've routed out, even though this is a very tough wood maple, you've still weakened that part of the wood itself. So like I say, don't be too shy with it. There's little burrs just so it goes in neatly. You want to get these little burrs off, because you don't want it jeopardising the look of the actual piece. Okay, so the next job is to create the back of the frame to hold the perspex, the picture, and the hardboard. So I've actually still got some bed frame left. So what I'm going to do is take this piece here, I'm going to rip it down and stick it to the back of the pieces here that are still gluing at the moment. What I'm going to do is I'm going to stick these strips of pine bed frame to the back of the maple frame here. I'm going to leave about 10mm gap from the top, where the viewing point of the frame is going to be, and that's where the hardboard and the picture and everything is going to sit on. That's handy. One of them actually broke because of the knot in it. I'm pretty sure I should be able to get... Yep. Brilliant. Just right. So that leaves me with one spare piece, but that'll just come in handy for another project. Just a couple of clamps to keep that in place. Not too bad looking, is it? What you need to do now is just give it a light sand, and then give it a couple of coats of varnish, and then it'll be ready. What I've done is I've set up this little area of polythene just so I don't spray it, because all I'm going to be using is this yacht spray varnish, because I'm not actually using it, and I'm intrigued to see what it's going to be like. If it screws it up, I'm going to be really annoyed. Here's a good idea if you can't quite get your crosspin hammer, your little hammer down to the nails when putting in the back of the board, back of the frame rather. Just get a screwdriver, flathead, and just put it up against the nail and just, if you've got it on the actual workbench, and just get the screwdriver and that should drive the nail in just right. What I've done here is I've wound some picture framing wire into two loops on the other end and just stapled it in with my automatic stapler, and that should hold pretty nicely. I hope it should do, it's not that heavy to be fair. And that is the finished piece. It's quite nice. So there you have it, another frame. Sorry to subject you to that again, but I needed to make another one because I've had it planned for a while, so I'm really sorry. But however, I do feel it's turned out really well this time. It's a really nice frame. I think I pulled off the Art Deco look a bit. I mean, if you disagree, then please let me know, but I think I did. So yeah, project done, another one completed. I think we'll go back to the shop projects, that's the word I'm looking for. I think we're going back to a shop project next time. So I hope you enjoyed that, thanks for watching, and please give me a thumbs up or subscribe if you haven't already. And I also want to give my thanks to Steve Backer, who I think that's how you pronounce it. If I'm wrong in saying that, please correct me. But I would like to, like I say, give my thanks to Steve Backer, who is always posting encouraging comments on my videos, which is, you know, much appreciated. It's really good. It's always nice to have support out there. And please feel free to check out any of my subscriptions. There's some really good ones on there, like Wrangle Star, Steve Ramsey, John Heist. I think his name's pronounced Heist. He's done some really cool projects. Another one I've just started watching is what's it? DIY for Knuckleheads, which is really cool. An Aussie guy who's just awesome. He's got some really, really good palette or used wood ideas. I think it's mostly palette wood and hardwood fence panels that he uses, but he's really, really cool. He's done some really good projects, so check him out because he's really funny as well. thanks for watching, and I suppose that's it. So until next time, take care, see you later.